Hello friends, welcome to the course on genetics. In this video we are going to learn chloroplast inheritance. It is type of cytoplasmic inheritance and in which we will study the example variegation in 4 o'clock plant. So let us see the example. The concept of cytoplasmic inheritance we already discussed in last video. What is cytoplasmic inheritance? Now we are going to study an example. So this particular inheritance we have to see in the plant 4 o'clock plant. It is also known as Mirabilis jalapa. So scientific name of this plant, it is Mirabilis jalapa. So this cytoplasmic inheritance of chloroplast, it was first of all given by the scientist Carl Korens in 1908. So it has been discovered first of all in 4 o'clock plant. Mirabilis jalapa plant, it contains 3 types of branches and leaves. So unlike other plants, so normally plant contains only one type of branches and only one type of leaves, but this plant it contains different types of branches and different types of leaves present. So generally there are 3 types of branches you can find in this plant. First type of branch, it is full green branches and leaves having chloroplasts. Full green means the branches are totally green in color. See here, these are the green color branch. Here you can see all the leaves are fully green in color. So such type of branches you can find, one type of branch or one type of leaves. Second, it is having white branches and leaves without chloroplast and it contains leucoplast, means instead of chloroplast, means colored pigment, it contains white pigments. They are called as leucoplast and they have the zero role in the process of photosynthesis. So the plants with such type of leucoplast or branches with such type of leucoplast only, they cannot photosynthesize and they cannot produce their own food. So such type of branches are also seen here. This is the same plant but it contains different types of branches. So these are the first type of branch, this is the second type of branch. So this branch you can see there is no any green pigmentation found, chloroplast found. So entire part of this plant, it is white in color, branch, leaves, etc. So all are white in color because they contains leucoplast instead of chloroplast. So this is the second type. Now third type, it is having variegated branches with white and green patches. So sometimes the combination of these two, means this type of branch, variegated branches, may contains green and white patches present, means they contain some part of the branch, it contains chloroplast, and some part of the branches it contains leucoplast. So here you can see this example. So here this is leaf, it contains some part green in color, some part it has white patches. Here also you can see, here also this variegated main branch or main shoot and leaves are also variegated. Here also you can see, so variegation you can see in entire shoot as well as in the leaves. So these are the third type of branches. So Mirabilis jalapa plant, it contains 3 type of branches. So we know very well, without chlorophyll pigments there is no possibility to produce any type of food. So the white branches which are present on the same plant, they cannot produce food or they cannot synthesize food because they lack chlorophyll pigments. So they take their food or they fulfill their food need from the green branches which are having chlorophyll pigments and have the capacity to produce their own food. So green branches, as they contain chlorophyll, they have the capacity to produce, synthesize their own food, and such type of food is which is produced by green branches, it is supplied and provided to the white branches, and on the same plant white branches will be become survive, or they remain survive. But if such type of white plants are produced, they will not survive because they contains no any branch with chlorophyll pigments, and there will be no food synthesis at all, and so that such type of plant will die immediately. So this is the sketch of our plant Mirabilis jalapa. It contains, already we have discussed, these are green branches, these are white branches, and this is the variegated main shoot, main branch, and also leaves are also having variegated colors, or they are having patches of chloroplast and leucoplast present. So this is the plant Mirabilis jalapa. Now, according to observation of Korens, a plant may contain two types of plastids. We have already discussed. First is chloroplast, they are green in color, and second is leucoplast, they are white and pale in color. They can produce synthesized food, but they can't synthesize any type of food. So regardless of genotype and phenotype of pollen parents, the flowers on green branches and flowers on white branches will produce green and white, that is pale offsprings respectively. So here one thing we have to note, that if we are selecting two parents, suppose parent one, it is suppose pollen grains, that is male parent, and parent second, it is female parents, suppose this is egg cells. So our statement says, regardless of genotype and phenotype of pollen parents, so pollen parent will not play any role, its genotype or phenotype plays no any role in the production of offspring. The offspring or phenotype of offspring, it is only depend upon the egg, so it is depend upon the female parent only. So genotype and phenotype of pollen parent, it is not taken, or it is not so much importance. The flowers on green branches and flowers on white branches will produce green and white pale, that is white means pale offspring. So the if we are selecting flowers of green branches, that is female parent green branches, they will produce offspring green in color. So they will produce green colored offspring because we have selected the female parent or female flowers from the green branch, so they will produce green type of offspring. If we are selecting parents, it is suppose white in color, means it has all leucoplast present, it regardless of the genotype and phenotype of the male parent, this will produce white colored branches. So this is very important for to understand the concept of this cytoplasmic inheritance in chloroplast, because only female parents plays very important role in the phenotypic expression of the offspring. So here you can say male parents are only required for the crossing, and they will not play any role in the expression of phenotype. They plays very only role of fertilization and not any phenotypic expression. So white, that is pale plant, will not grow further and die as it lacks chlorophyll pigments and cannot produce its own food. So as we have discussed already, pale plants, if produced, suppose here you can see we have selected white colored egg and we have selected the pollen grains. As we know, pollen grain plays no any role in the process of or in the expression of phenotype. If we are selecting white flowers from white branch, they will produce white offspring, and suppose these are white the seeds of white plant or white branch, so these seeds will not germinate and if they germinate they will become die, because due to the inability of leucoplasts to photosynthesize they will not survive, they can't produce their own food and these plants will be die immediately. Now we have seen two cases. We have selected first of all the flowers from the green branch and after that flowers from the white branch. Third thing has been remained. The flower from the variegated branch yields mixed progeny of green, white, pale and variegated plants in varying ratio. So likewise these flowers from green plant and flower from pale or white branch, we also select flower from the variegated branch. If we select the flowers from the variegated branch, here also only female plays important role, because this variegated branch contains all types of colors or pigments present here. They contains green pigment, they contains white and pale pigments, and they also contains variegated, means it contains mixture of both. So if we are selecting a flowers from a branch which having variegated colors, then it will produce three types of branches or three types of progeny. That is, such plant will produce green color branches, also they will produce white color branches, and they also produce variegated offsprings. So the flower from the variegated branches, they will produce all three type of branches. So it is given in tabular form here. Branch of origin of pollen grain, suppose we have selected the pollen grain from green branch, we have here selected pollen grain from white or pale branch, then we have selected pollen grain from variegated branch. So see here, these are males, that is pollen grains, and we have selected female parent from different branches. So we have, first of all, we will cross this green the pollen grain from green branch with green branch female parent, it will give rise to green colored progeny, or the plant will be green in color, means it contains all photosynthetic pigments present. Here we can't get any idea whether this green color came from this female plant or green plant, but here you can get know from where it has been come. So same green pollen grains or the pollen grains from green branch, we will cross them with white or pale colored female parent. If this pollen grain playing any role in the phenotypic expression, the branches will be of different types, but here you can see same type of branches are have been produced as like female parents. So white or pale branch we have selected, or flowers from white and pale parents we have selected, then they will give rise to pale or white colored flowers. Now in third case, we have kept same, that is males, but we have changed the branch, that is variegated branch, or we have selected flowers from variegated branch. This particular cross will produce green, pale, white colored variegated types of plants. So three types of plant can be produced here, that is green, pale, white and variegated. So these characters also have been evolved from the females, that is female branch of the plant. Now we are selecting, in second case we are selecting the pollen grains from white or pale branch. Now same thing, we are first of all crossing them with green, they will produce green. Here it is also clear that the phenotypic expression of female is there, and know any role of this pollen grains or male parent. In this case, you can see pale and white color flowers have been produced. If we produce or we cross white into white or pale into pale, it will give rise to pale or white colored flowers. So in third case, if we are choosing variegated females and if you are crossing with white or pale color, so here also male parent it will not play any role. Variegated branch of variegated flowers of female branch, they will again expressed phenotypically. So green, pale or white and variegated offspring have been obtained. Now in third case, we have selected variegated, that is pollen grains, that is male parent, and we have selected all same similar type of female parents. Green, again it will give green. White and variegated, it will again give white or pale. And in third case, variegated, here also this female parent will be expressed and it will give three types of offspring: green, pale or white, and variegated. So this is very important table to understand what is actual the phenotypic expression of the offspring. Now from the above example, it is obvious that progeny always resembles to female and male made no any contribution. So progeny or phenotype type of progeny, it is as like female only, and male contributes only for fertilization and it will not play any role in the phenotypic expression of the progeny. So as it has very less cytoplasm and mostly devoid of plastid. So why this male cannot contribute phenotypically in the progeny? Because it has very less cytoplasm. Male has no cytoplasm and mostly devoid of plastids. So if there is no cytoplasm, there will be no any cell organelles. Chloroplasts are not present or it contains no any type of plastid. So it will not contribute any cytoplasm here. Only female parent or female cytoplasm is contributed, so that the offspring or the progeny, it will only as like female. So this will give us clear idea that female parents plays very important role in the phenotypic expression of the progeny. Now the reason behind the unusual pattern of inheritance is that genes responsible for color of plastids, they are always present in cytoplasm. So here you can understand the concept of cytoplasmic inheritance, because here you can see only female parents are contributing a lot because they have very bulky cytoplasm and male has no any cytoplasm or very less cytoplasm. So female parent will contribute in the production of or in the phenotypic expression, because genes responsible for color of plastids are always present in cytoplasm, and cytoplasm is present in females only, so not in nucleus, and are therefore transmitted only from the female parent. So the genes for plastid, that is production of color, they are present in cytoplasm and they are not present in nucleus. So that if cytoplasm is present, or the cytoplasm of which parent it will involved in the progeny, that only expressed phenotypically. As we know, the female cytoplasm is bigger and bulky than male cytoplasm, so it will actively take part into the phenotypic expression of the progeny. And the genes for the plastid or chloroplast, leucoplast, etc., they are present into the cytoplasm only, and so that the cytoplasm, it will express itself and they are therefore transmitted only from the female parents. So zygote normally receives the bulk of cytoplasm from the egg cell and male gamete contribute very little. So chloroplasts are self-replicating organelles and transmitted through the cytoplasm of egg cell during sexual reproduction. So they are not inherited through the pollen grains. So chloroplasts, they are self-replicating, as we have discussed already. They contain their own DNA and they contain their own replication machinery. So these are very important organelles and they transmitted through the cytoplasm of egg cell only. So these chloroplasts, they are transmitted, this is very important sentence, they transmitted through the cytoplasm of egg cell only, not of pollen grain cytoplasm. So this will happen during the sexual reproduction. So they are not inherited through the pollen grain. So here we can see pollen grain not play any role in the phenotype. So progeny will show only characteristics of female parents. So the inheritance is also known as maternal inheritance, or this is also known as uniparental inheritance. So why? See here, only maternal means phenotypic expression of only female characters have been take place here. So this particular inheritance is called as maternal inheritance, and as only one parent is showing its phenotypic expression in progeny, then it is also known as uniparental inheritance. Uniparental inheritance. Why? Because only female parent it will expressed phenotypically, so that it is known as uniparental inheritance. So that in our introductory video, we have seen introductory video of cytoplasmic inheritance, we have seen that the cytoplasmic inheritance, it can be variously known by maternal inheritance, uniparental inheritance. Also it is known as extra chromosomal, extra nuclear and non-chromosomal. So all these are the different names for the cytoplasmic inheritance. So you must understand why it is known as maternal inheritance or why it is known as uniparental inheritance. So these are some references for your study. Thanks for your attention.